There was a time when we used to foresee the success or defeat of some people in terms of their IQ. Ang paniwala, kapag mataas ang IQ, mas successful. Pero nitong mga nakaraang taon, marami pong pinag-uusapan na iba't iba naman talaga ang intelligence. Ang alam nating intelligence, halimbawa, intelligence sa math, o kaya intelligence sa language, intelligence sa philosophy. Pero meron tayong mga kakilalang tao na hindi ganong kagaling sa math o sa philosophy, pero practical ang kanilang intelligence. Ibig sabihin, sila yung magre-repair ng sirang kotse, alam nila agad kung paano baklasin at alam nila kung paano buuin. Practical, makita pa lang yung kahoy, alam na kung pwedeng anong gawin dun sa kahoy. Practical, yung mga hindi kaya ng philosophers, yung mga hindi kaya ng bankers, kayang-kaya nila. Caring-carry. Pero hindi lang practical intelligence, meron ding aesthetic intelligence, artistic intelligence. Ang ibig sabihin nito ay magaling sa drama, pero mapurol sa math. Ibig sabihin nito, magaling sa painting at saka drawing, pero mahina sa language. Pero aesthetic ang kanilang intelligence. Ibang intelligence yun, pero intelligence pa rin yun. Pero ngayon pong hapon, let us look at another intelligence. Not just philosophical, mathematical, or literary. Not just practical or aesthetic intelligence. Meron pong pinag-uusapang moral intelligence. Anong ibig sabihin ng moral intelligence? Yung ibig sabihin noon ay character. Ibig sabihin noon ay integrity. Ibig sabihin noon ay marangal na tao. Ibig sabihin noon ay matuwid na tao. Ibig sabihin noon ay tao na alam mong magandang asal, may nakatingin o kahit nakatago. Moral intelligence. Ito po yung character. Even if no one sees you, ito po yung integrity, whether everybody sees you or you are hidden. Pero ang tanong ay, paano natin na-develop yung mathematical intelligence? Paano natin na-develop yung philosophical intelligence o aesthetic intelligence o practical intelligence? Yung iba sasabihin na mana sa magulang. Pero yung iba sasabihin, training at pinaghirapan, pinag-aralan. Pero ang tanong, paano natin napapataas ang ating moral intelligence? Tanong ko kayo, sa mga pangyayari sa ating buhay, kailan tayo mas maraming natutunan? Nung successful o nung natalo? Kailan mas lumalim yung pagkatao mo? Nung marami kang medalya sa graduation? O yung bumagsak ka at hindi mo na makalimutan yun habang buhay, na nagturo sa iyo ng isang aral na hanggang ngayon sinasabuhay mo? My dear brothers and sisters, the reality is we learn best and we teach character. We grow in character. We grow deeply in character by trials, by difficulties, by crisis. Many people learn life's important lessons in jail. Many people learn their life's important lessons in the hospital while sick. Many people learn the important lessons in life when they were defeated, when they were sued, when they were maligned, when they were calumniated, when they were gossiped about unfairly, and yet they became better persons because of these. Yung bang alam mo na mayroong hindi tama at hindi maganda sa buhay mo? Lasenggo yung tatay ko. Ang taba-tabang chismosa ng nanay ko. Yung kuya ko, drug addict. Yung ate ko, single mother. Pagkatapos ako, repeater. 3 taon ako nag grade 6. Pagkatapos noon, ano pa? Ako pa, kamuntik pa akong makulong. Pero sa mga pagkakataong ito, pwede tayong magpalalim ng karakter. Pero bakit yung iba ay lalong nawala ng karakter dahil sa problemang ito? Alam niyo kung bakit? Iisa lang talaga ang dahilan. God. God. When you put God into your poverty, you are blessed. When you put God as you weep, you are blessed. When you put God as they exclude you are blessed. When you put God as they insult you are blessed. When you put God as they denounce you are blessed. When you put God when they speak all kinds of evil against you are blessed. The important word, the important connection, my dear brothers and sisters, is God. And when you put everything attached to God, your character deepens, integrity deepens, and your moral intelligence increases. Nakailang politiko na tayo? Nakailang eleksyon na tayo? Nakailang pangako na tayo? Nakailang scandal na tayo? Nakailang kaso na tayo sa Sandigan Bayan? Nakailang Senate hearing na tayo tungkol sa corruption? Ano nangyari? Bakit ganito pa rin tayo? Alam niyo ang nangyari? Iniwanan natin ang Panginoon. The Lord is lacking in this country. That is why our poverty is not a blessing. That is why the insults are not blessing us. That is why the problems are not blessing us. That is why our tears have not become our blessings, because we have abandoned the Lord. The gospel blesses those who are poor, who are hungry, who are weeping, who are insulted, who are excluded, who are cursed on account of the Son of Man. On account of the Son of Man. Ang ibig sabihin, kung mahirap ka, pero wala namang kinalaman ng Diyos, talagang tamad ka lang, that is not beatitude. Kung umiiyak ka dahil sa kalukuhan mo, kasi humiwalay ka sa Diyos, that is not beatitude. Kung ikaw ay nagugutom, kung ikaw ay nalulungkot, pero dahil humiwalay ka sa Diyos, that is not beatitude. It is only on account of the Son of Man, on account of God, that our poverty, our weeping, our hunger, our thirst, our exclusion becomes our blessing, and it builds character. Ngayong linggong ito, anong panalangin natin? Ang laki sa layaw, paglaki ay hubad. Ang laki sa layaw ay walang matututunan. Pag lumaki sa layaw at hindi tayo nasanay sa hirap ng buhay, paglaki natin, bulak-bulero ka pa rin habang panahon. Let us build our moral intelligence, and build our moral intelligence by growing deeply in courage, in generosity. When we are tried, face the trial. When we are tested, face the testing. When we are examined, face the examination. Because all these pains that come your way will only make you a better person.